You know, today the board approved the reinstatement of Grambling's nursing program. It's a program that was successful for 30 years, and it's a very exciting day for that community, for the nursing profession, and certainly for Grambling State University. You know, we couldn't be more grateful to Governor John Bel Edwards and the legislators who came together and crafted a solution to the current year problem that did not cut higher education. You know, investments in our students, in our universities, in our communities have a significant return that empowers all of us, especially our taxpayers and our employers. They made the right decision, and we applaud them for their efforts. You know, by any measure, we rank near the bottom in terms of funding for higher education, especially when you look at a per-student basis. In the Southern Region Education Board, it's the 16 southern states. When you look at funding per student, total funding, state funding, tuition, and fees, we rank 16th out of 16 states. In fact, for the last 11 years, 7 of those years, we've ranked dead last. 3 of those years, we ranked 15th. And at our highest point, we ranked 12th. That's unit cost. But those units are students. They're our future. We've got to find ways to reinvest. And listen, I understand the challenge. We have the scarcity equation in place. Unlimited wants for very limited resources. And our policymakers have got to make decisions that ensure that our economy is viable, that our employers can compete. But at the same time, we've got to invest in our people, and we look forward to working with them to find that right balance.
We had a report earlier on the 2017 special session, and as we know, it ended on a very good note for higher education. I do want to remind you that higher education has suffered about $100 million in cuts this fiscal year already. So we're still not at where we were last year, which was the 16th ranked state out of 16 southern states in funding per student. In fact, over the last 11 years, 7 of those years, we've ranked 16th out of 16 states in funding per student. In the business world, we call that unit cost. So our unit cost has been the lowest in the South for 7 years. 3 of those 11 years, we were ranked 15th. And in 1 year, when we reached the highest investment in higher education in our state's history, we skyrocketed up to number 12 out of 16. The ability of our universities to perform at a high level is a testament to our faculty, to our staff, to our leadership, our presidents. However, as we move forward into this next regular session of our legislature, we have got to continue to work very closely with our policymakers and our lawmakers to ensure that we reinvest in our students, because they're our future. I think our message is resonating. I know that we have immense support. I also realize that our legislators are dealing with a fiscal crisis that is almost without precedent. And they have got to balance policy such that we have an environment that's conducive to economic growth and prosperity, and at the same time, we're providing the services to our citizenry. The scarcity equation is very real. There are unlimited wants, unlimited demands on very limited resources. And so we don't battle at the legislature. We work collaboratively with these policymakers and with our governor to ensure that we make these investments, and we appreciate your help. Earlier this week, Chair Perkins and I had lunch with the chairs of the other higher education boards and the system presidents, so it was the five families, I guess, around the table.
With no baseball bats.
No baseball bats. We kept looking behind us. And we had a discussion primarily around the Board of Regents' response to Act 619. Earlier this week, they released a revised report. The first report came out in January, where they solicited feedback. We got amazing feedback from our presidents, from our faculty, from our staff. They amended the report, and in some ways they amended it in a very good way. They reaffirmed the importance of our statewide research institutions, that's UNO, Louisiana Tech, and University of Louisiana at Lafayette, ULL, Mr. Bruno. The original draft had PhD programs restricted from these institutions. That has been corrected. And I want to thank the Regents for working with us and reaffirming the mission of these critical universities that last year generated $120 million in sponsored research. It's fantastic, and those institutions will continue. I also applaud them for recognizing the need for appropriate practitioner level doctorate degrees at our regional universities. And we have a doctor of pharmacy, for example, at ULM. We have doctors of education, doctors of nurse practitioner at our regional universities, and they are absolutely essential to the growth of those regional economies. In general, the response to Act 619 is very favorable, but we have articulated to the Board of Regents that we desperately need to refocus our attention less on measures of inputs, less on accountability to process, less on measures of efficiencies. When you're $1,200 per student more efficient than the next most efficient state, you might want to point your attention elsewhere. And we have encouraged them strongly to focus our attention on educational attainment. The nature of work is changing. And those citizens that are prepared to engage in the 21st century economy are those that can think critically, they can solve problems, they can communicate effectively, they can use technology. They're prepared for this season of increasingly rapid change. It's vitally important that we make these investments and we put a target out there, an audacious vision for educational attainment of our citizenry. It's going to be essential to the growth of our communities, the growth of our employers, and certainly the growth of the students that we serve. I believe that that message is starting to resonate, and I believe that we'll see some favorable action in that regard. The Board of Regents will meet tomorrow to receive the report, and we look forward to working very closely with them to effect this new vision. Earlier today, as you know, we have two presidential searches that are beginning. Earlier today, the McNeese State Presidential Search Committee met, received its charge, discussed the search process, and reviewed and approved the advertisement and timeline. This afternoon at 1 o'clock, it's coming very soon, Northwestern State University Presidential Search Committee will meet and follow a similar process. We've established web pages on our site for both searches and we'll update the site as needed. Of course, at any point, if you have questions regarding either search, feel free to reach out. I believe that the highest calling, the most important duty of this board is to select presidents to run our universities. And I'm excited about this journey will be beginning, and we look forward to ensuring that the presidents that lead those institutions are worthy of the students, faculty, and staff and communities they serve. An update on the UL System Student Advisory Council. Supervisor Torres, our young man, Mr. Kenny, met them in Washington at Washington Mardi Gras. They had their eyes open to a new form of Louisiana government that exists when 3,000 leaders from our state gather in the Hilton Ballroom. But during the week leading up to that, they were able to meet with a number of policymakers, lawmakers, see the inner workings of government at the national level. They represented us so ably. They carried an incredible message about their future. They were well received. They certainly were well behaved, as far as I know. Supervisor Torres can give us the stories. But I was so proud of them. I also want to thank Harold Butte from the Louisiana Board of Regents, who helped coordinate that trip, and Drake Owens, who helped coordinate the efforts to raise money so these students could attend the ball on Saturday night. It was a great event, and I know that they enjoyed it. They appeared to be enjoying it quite a bit. The Academic Summit, the 6th Annual University of Louisiana System Academic Summit, will be held Thursday, March 30th, and Friday, March 31st, on the campus of Southeastern Louisiana University in Hammond. This summit is the system's premier academic event and is an opportunity to highlight the great work happening at our universities on an undergraduate level. It also encourages collaboration among our institution students and faculty. As Rachel mentioned in the Legislative Committee, UL System Day at the Capitol is scheduled for Wednesday, April 19th, which will immediately precede the Thursday, April 20th committee board meetings. April 19th is not a great day for many of our universities. It is impossible to find a great day for all of our universities and our board. It is the best possible day for us to advocate and carry our message to the legislature. I want to thank Chairman Perkins for his vision on UL System Day. I think you will find it a great day to celebrate our collective work. Last night we had our first reception in this new season of our board. President Gallo and his team from Grambling did an extraordinary job of putting an event together for our board and many of our stakeholders to socialize, to fellowship. He raised the bar. The next president has got a huge bar to overcome. So thank you for that, President Gallo, and to your team at Grambling. And Mr. Chairman, that concludes my remarks.
Thank you, Dr. Henderson. For my report, a couple of things. The trusteeship conference, just a reminder to place on your calendars, that Monday, March 20th, the Board of Regents annual trusteeship conference held at Pennington in Baton Rouge. This is the event and time when Regents hosts all the state higher education boards, presents a program and a discussion that are beneficial to all. I know I've been asked to serve on a panel along with the chairpersons of the other higher ed boards, so we look forward to that. Board members, if you have not gotten information, please contact Dr. Henderson in his office in order to get further information. Our board retreat is coming up on March 31st. First of all, I want to thank Dr. Henderson and Dr. Kahn for taking the role in helping to plan this event. This is something that I've personally been very passionate about since January, and saying we need to get it done and to have the most participation that we can from our board. I know as of this time, I think we have a very strong support from the board participating, board members participating in it. The board retreat will be held at Nicholls University, Nicholls State University, with Dr. Murphy will be hosting us there. We're currently working on agenda and hope to have more information within the next couple weeks. There are a block of rooms that have been reserved at the Hampton Inn in Thibodeau. Please advise the staff of your plans to participate and whether you need overnight accommodations. I know Dr. Henderson has been working on possible presentation, and we're working together on what the curriculum may be. I know we've reached out to our general counsels, Quirk, Clark, and Adams, with the possibility of them doing presentations as well to make sure that we're all are educated on updates in the law and dealing with board duties.